Okay, children, so in the previous lecture we had done till question number 17. Now let us proceed. So next topic, complex plane or argand plane. Complex plane or argand plane. So what do we understand by that? So let us see this. So suppose I have a complex number, okay, x plus iy, okay. So this is nothing but it's a ordered pair, okay, x comma y, okay. So complex number, this corresponds to the ordered pair xy, and it can be represented by the point p x comma y in the xy plane, okay. So we have got this x coordinate system, okay, xy plane, okay. So if I want to represent this x plus iy, okay, geometrically, okay, then I can represent this real part on the x-axis, okay, and I can represent the imaginary part on the y-axis. Clear? For example, if I have 3 plus 5y, okay, if I have a complex number 3 plus 5y, okay, then in xy plane I can denote it as point A 3 comma 5, okay. This minus 4 plus 3i is a complex number. You want to denote it geometrically, okay, then you can represent as this, as a point, okay, minus 4 comma 3, done, where your real part is always represented on x-axis and your imaginary part is represented on y-axis, okay. So it's same as plotting as points, okay, where you are taking the real part on the x-axis, okay, and the imaginary part on the y-axis. So the xy plane is known as the complex plane, okay, or the argand plane. X-axis is called the real axis and the y-axis is called the imaginary axis. So complex plane means this, okay, xy plane. Complex plane means xy plane, where your real part is represented on x-axis and your imaginary part is represented on the y-axis. Clear? So and next is, next is polar form of a complex number. Okay, polar form of a complex number. So suppose I have a complex number z is equal to x plus iy. I have a complex number z is equal to x plus iy. Okay, be a complex number, then its polar form. Okay, I want to write this in the polar form. So that polar form is given as this. Polar form of this complex number is written as r, and inside the bracket, cos theta plus I sine theta. Okay, so the same complex number z in the polar form is written as r in bracket cos theta plus I sine theta. Now what is your r and what is your theta? Okay, so here r is nothing but it's a square root of x square plus y square. Okay, so suppose you have a complex number x plus iy, okay, and you want to write that in polar form, okay, then that would be written in the in this way, r cos theta plus I sine theta, where your r will be calculated from this formula, okay, square root of x square plus y square, okay, and your theta is nothing but amplitude, okay, your theta is nothing but amplitude, okay. But previously when we are finding amplitude, okay, we were not that specific while finding the theta, okay. We were not that specific while finding the theta. But when we are going to write any complex number in terms of polar form, okay, in that case, your theta has to be specific, okay. Like here, you see that this point A, okay, it is in the first quadrant, okay. So when I join this A and this origin, okay, if I draw a line from this point, okay, till this origin, so some angle will be made, yes or no, okay. Understanding? So you have to be specific what is that angle, okay. Like here, this is a complex number, okay. When I join this point and this origin, in that case this theta will be different, yes. So you have to be specific while finding the theta, okay. So if you have got a complex number x plus iy, then that can be written in polar form, okay, with this formula, okay, where your r is nothing but square root of x square plus y square and your theta is nothing but amplitude of that complex number which is given as tan inverse y upon x. Okay, here I have taken z is equal to x plus iy, that's why tan inverse y upon x. If I had taken it z is equal to a plus ib, then I would have written tan inverse b upon a. Okay, this, okay. Okay, suppose I have this complex number is there, x plus iy, then in complex plane, okay, in complex plane, this complex number can be denoted by the point P x comma y. Okay, so this is the complex number, okay, P. Now if I join this point P, okay, with this origin, then you can see there is a straight line. Okay, so whatever is the length of this OP, whatever is the length of this OP, that is only your R, that is only your R. Okay, and since this point is x comma y, so from O till this point, okay, is x, and from this point till this P is y. Okay, and this angle made between the angle this XOP, okay, is called the theta. That is only your amplitude. Clear? So if you want to write your x in terms of r and theta, then you can use the trigonometric ratio and you can write, okay, same way you can write your y, that is equal to r sine theta. Done. So let us come to see how to find the amplitude of a complex number. Okay, though we had done in first lecture only, okay, but this method will help you to find the specific amplitude, okay, for that complex number. So when, suppose you have been given a complex number x plus iy, okay, you have been given a complex number x plus iy and I want the amplitude. Okay, so step one is, what you'll do is find the value of tan inverse mod, okay, this is mod, okay, y upon x. Okay, so mod means the absolute value, positive value. Okay, suppose if I write mod and in within that mod minus 1, okay, that means if I write mod minus 1, then answer will be 1. Okay, if I write mod minus 2, then answer will be 2. Okay, so mod means, that means absolute value, okay, positive value. So first step is find the value of tan inverse mod y upon x lying between 0 and pi by 2, that means 90, 0 and 90. So we will find this value, first step, okay, and that value we will denote by alpha. Okay, that value will be denoted by alpha. Clear? Step two, find the quadrant in which the given complex number, okay, lies. Okay, so we have to find that where does that complex number lies, okay, in the first, second, third or fourth quadrant. Okay, then according to that, okay, we will find the amplitude, or we say argument. Suppose here, like, we have considered the complex number x plus iy, okay, so x means it is represented on x-axis, y represented on y-axis. So suppose x is greater than 0 and y is greater than 0, okay, that means that complex number lies in the first quadrant. Okay, so in that case your amplitude or the argument will be same as what you have found in the first step. Okay, number two, if x is less than 0, that means negative, okay, and y is greater than 0, that means positive, that means in that case your complex number is in the second quadrant. Okay, and in that case your amplitude, or you say the argument, is nothing but pi minus alpha. Pi minus alpha, alpha is found in the first step. Okay, next, if x is less than 0 and y is also less than 0, that means both are negative, that means the point, the complex number is in the third quadrant. Okay, in that case amplitude or the argument is given by minus, okay, and in the bracket pi minus alpha. Here alpha is found in first step. The last condition, okay, if you see that x is greater than 0 and y is less than 0, okay, that means your point or the complex number is in the fourth quadrant. In that case, amplitude or the argument will be minus alpha. Okay, now these things will get much clearer, okay, if you get if you see these examples. Okay, so I have taken example for each. Okay, so let us see the first example. Here my complex number is 1 plus square root of 3, okay, into I. Okay, so here I want to find the amplitude of this complex number. So first what I'll do, okay, first step says that you should find alpha. Okay, alpha equal to tan inverse mod y by x. So first step what I'll do, I'll find the alpha. So alpha equal to tan inverse y by x. Here in place of y we have square root of 3 and in x we have 1. Okay, so square root of 3 upon this. Okay, so it's already positive only. So in next step, tan inverse square root of 3. Now we will write the angle, okay, which will be within, we will write the angle which will be within 0 and 90. Okay, okay, for which tan gives root 3. Okay, and that angle is pi by 3. Pi by 3, done. Now we have done the first step. Now in the second step we have to check that where does this this complex number lies. Okay, so clearly this is one positive, this is positive root 3, that means 1 comma square root of 3. Okay, so that means this complex number is in the first quadrant. Okay, and if it is in the first quadrant, then argument will be same as this alpha. Okay, this is what the first condition says. Okay, so if it is in the first quadrant, then in that case argument will be alpha only. Okay, that's why, so argument is pi by 3 only. Okay, next, z is equal to minus 4 plus 4 root 3i. Okay, so first step we'll find the alpha. So alpha is tan inverse mod 4 root 3 upon minus 4. You know what does this mod do? So it'll give you the positive value. Okay, so tan inverse 4 root 3 upon 4, so 4 4 cancel, so you get tan inverse root 3. And what angle for what angle tan gives you root 3, that is pi by 3. Okay, now next step is to see where does this lie. So clearly the x is negative and this y is positive. Okay, that means this complex number is in the second quadrant. Okay, and if you have the complex number in the second quadrant, okay, then your argument will be pi minus alpha. Okay, alpha is found in the first step, so already we have the alpha pi by 3. Okay, so argument will be pi minus alpha, that means 2 pi upon 3. Okay, next, z is equal to minus 2 root 3 minus 2i. okay, so here we'll find the alpha first. So we get tan inverse in mod, okay, minus 2 upon minus 2 root 3, so we'll get the positive value over here. So tan inverse 2 upon 2 root 3 equal to tan inverse 1 upon root 3. We know that for pi by 6 tan gives 1 by root 3, that's why pi by 6. Now we will check, okay, second step we will check this lies in which quadrant. So this lies in the third quadrant. Okay, so if it lies in the third quadrant, what does the formula says? That argument will be minus pi minus alpha. Okay, so that's why we get minus pi minus alpha. Okay, so it comes minus 5 pi by 6. Next, z is equal to 5 root 3 minus 5 i. Okay, so first step, find the alpha. So tan inverse minus 5 upon 5 by minus 5 upon 5 root 3. Okay, in the mod, so we get positive value, tan inverse 5 upon 5 root 3. Okay, tan inverse 1 by root 3, that is pi by 6. Now clearly this lies in which quadrant? This lies in the fourth quadrant. Okay, because x is positive, y is negative. Okay, so it is in the fourth quadrant. And what do we have condition for the fourth quadrant? In that case argument will be minus alpha. So that's why argument is minus alpha, that means minus pi by 6. Now I have taken few questions. These questions are not from your book. Okay, so these questions are taken from other book. So question is, represent each of the following complex numbers in the polar form. So we have to represent each of the following complex numbers in the polar form. Okay, So let us see the first one. Okay, here it says your number is 3. Okay, that means your complex number is 3, and we have to represent this in polar form. So let z is equal to 3. Firstly, we'll write in the form of a plus ib if it is not. Okay, so clearly it is not in the form a plus ib. So first we'll write in form of a plus ib. So this can be written z is equal to 3 plus 0 into I. Okay, now you can see that clearly this z lies in which quadrant? It lies in the first quadrant. Okay, because x is positive, y is positive. That means if I have to write in you have to represent in complex plane, I have to denote represent this in the first quadrant. So this complex number lies in the first quadrant. Okay, done. This information is known to you. Okay, this will help you to find your amplitude. Okay, next I have to write this into polar form. So we know that polar form, okay, it was explained over here that if I have z is equal to x plus iy, then polar form is z is equal to r cos theta plus I sine theta, where your r is equal to square root of x square plus y square, and theta is amplitude z tan inverse y upon x. Okay, so let us come to that question. So polar form of z is equal to 3 plus 0 I is z is equal to r cos theta plus I sine theta, where r is given by, okay, square root of x square plus y square. Okay, by that formula. So here x is 3 and y is 0, so that's why 3 square plus 0 square is equal to 3. So I got my r. Okay, now I have to find theta, that means amplitude. Okay, so for that, first step is to find the alpha. Okay, so alpha is equal to tan inverse 0 by 3. Okay, mean mod. Okay, so y by x, that means 0 by 3. So I get tan inverse 0 is equal to 0. Done. Now we know that we have the alpha equal to 0, and we know that the complex number lies in the first quadrant. Okay, so if it is lies in the first quadrant, in that case amplitude will be same as alpha. Okay, so here theta is 0. So I got my r also, I got my theta also. So r and theta will be put in equation star. Okay, and that way we can get the polar form for this complex number. Okay, so from star z will be equal to 3. Okay, in place of r, 3 is put, and in place of theta, 0 is put. Okay, you don't have to simplify, you have to leave it like this. Okay, so this is the polar form of this complex number. Okay, same way you have to do 2, 3, 4, 5. It's very simple. Till 6 you have to do. Okay, 7th I will do over here. Okay, so same way you have to do. Okay, I have given the answer also. Okay, so question 7, here z is equal to minus 1 plus root 3 I. Okay, so this complex number is given to us. Okay, and we have to write it in polar form. Okay, so first of all, just by seeing, you can say that this lies in the second quadrant, because x is minus negative and y is positive. That means this complex number is in the second quadrant. This information is going to help us to find the amplitude. Okay, now polar form of this complex number will be equal to will be given as z is equal to r cos theta plus I sine theta. Okay, so this is how the polar form, this is what the polar form of this. Okay, but we don't know the actual value of r, we don't know the actual value of theta. So we have to find the r, we have to find the theta. So for r, r is equal to square root of x square plus y square. So here x is what, minus 1, y is root 3. So done. So we'll get 2. So r comes 2. Now we have to find theta, that means we have to find amplitude. Theta means amplitude. So whatever we have discussed, okay, the method, we have to follow that. So first step is find the alpha. So alpha is equal to tan inverse, okay, mod root 3 upon minus 1. Okay, so positive value we have to take. So tan inverse root 3. So we have to see for what value tan gives you root 3. So it's pi by 3. So I got alpha equal to pi by 3. Okay, now what we'll do, we will get the exact value of theta. Okay, so how we will get that? For that we have to know this complex number lies in which quadrant? So it lies in the second quadrant. Okay, so I have alpha pi by 3 and z lies in the second quadrant. So we know that if the complex number lies in the second quadrant and we have got the alpha, okay, then the amplitude will be pi minus alpha. Okay, so theta comes 2 pi upon 3. So we got that theta also, okay, exact value of theta. So therefore replace r and theta in equation r, equation star. Okay, so you will get the polar form of that given complex number. Okay, next, this is also not from your book. Okay, convert the complex number minus 16 upon 1 plus I root 3 to the polar form. Okay, so here before converting this to polar form, firstly you got to write this in terms of a plus ib. Okay, because we know the polar form for a plus ib type, okay, or you can say polar form for x plus iy type. Okay, here we don't have something like x plus iy. Okay, so first convert this, that means you got to do rationalization and all and bring it down to a plus ib or x plus iy type. Okay, so here this is z. Okay, I have taken, let this be z, then rationalized. Okay, and I got z is equal to minus 4 plus 4 root 3i. Okay, so I got this in terms of x plus iy. Okay, clearly this lies in the second quadrant. Done. This will help us to find the theta, means amplitude. Next, polar form of this will be r cos theta plus I sin theta. Done. Now we will find the r. R is equal to square root of x square plus y square. Substitute the values, we will get 8. Okay, so we got the value of r. Now we are looking for the value of theta. Okay, that means amplitude. So you know the method. First you got to find the alpha. Okay, so alpha equal to tan inverse, okay, in mod y upon x. So here y is 4 root 3 upon x is minus 4. Done. The positive value, tan inverse root 3. Okay, for what value? Tan gives you root 3, that is pi by 3. Got. Now we know that the given complex number lies in the second quadrant, okay, and we have got the value of alpha. So in second quadrant, in that case amplitude will be pi minus alpha. Okay, so put that. So theta is equal to 2 pi upon 3. Done. Now what you do, substitute these values in equation star. Okay, so you get z is equal to 8 cos 2 pi upon 3 plus I sin 2 pi upon 3. Okay, so this is the required polar form, and this is all for today. Okay.